Hi, my name is Kelsey. I am here to show you the digital portion of the curriculum within brightwheel. So in the brightwheel account, your admins will go to the learning tab, and up at the top we have three tabs. One is called room plans, one is called library, and one is called portfolios. Under the library tab and under lesson plan templates, that is where each week will be auto-populated for the month for your admins to go in and view all the digital lessons for the month. So you can see I have preschool week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4 in here for Explore the Rainforest. Now they can assign these lessons to the room that it belongs to. So if we click in here to week one, we're going to assign it to the room that we'd like it to go to. Maybe it's our Moana room. And then this step is optional to assign it to a week. However, if they want it to show up within the calendar app of brightwheel, you have to have these dates in there. Otherwise, it will be in that classroom under the room plans, but it will not be in their app for the teachers. So we want to make sure that week is assigned, and then we're going to click assign. Once you've assigned those, you can see in the room plans everything assigned for that month and previous months. You can see down here there's a toggle that they can go back and see maybe what they did last month or the month before. But I have everything in here for the month of April. So we would go to the week that we need. Maybe I am a preschool teacher and we are in week 3. And here is all of the activities planned out for the week. Now your teachers can come in here and customize this. They can click and drag to move any activities. They can remove anything. They can also add any learning activities. All of these activities in here that they can add are all under the library and learning activities button, where they can also create their own. So maybe they're adding something in here, whatever it might be, they can add it here and create their own, something they've done from the past, whatever, it's in there. They can now add it to that week. So if we pop back into this room, once they have done all the customizations that they want, whether it's, you know, the section name, they can add times, they can remove what the name is, anything in here, we can now print this version to have it posted within their classrooms. And this toggle up here will allow them to share that with families. Again, they have to have the date assigned week in here for everybody to see it in the apps for the calendar view. Okay, so keep that in mind, that is very important. Teachers will be able to click into these activities, see if it's a large or small group, what we're doing, what skills we're working on, as well as the supplies list, how to set up our discussion, and then teachers can add notes. Families can also view everything up here, but they will not be able to see those additional notes. That is only visible to the staff. This note section is just for them to, you know, further customize each activity. Okay. And then over here on the left-hand side, they're able to click into the next activity for the day. The last thing that's really exciting in here is all the songs are available to your teachers right within the brightwheel app. Anything that they need for that day will be in here. They can click play and they can do that activity. Okay, so adding observations within brightwheel. We have our observation model, which is easy to follow, and it will ensure that you assess all 35 skills at regular intervals just by observing children as they naturally play. So when your teachers go into that weekly view, they're going to see a star next to at least one of the activities per day to notify them to make that observation. So when they click into that activity within brightwheel, they click add observation, and then they can select one or multiple students at a time. Under the skill assessment, you'll see all the skills associated to this activity, and we click the plus next to that student's name, and it's going to populate all the bench levels for the specific skill. This makes it easy for your teachers to quickly identify where that student is performing. So then we can select where the student is performing for each activity, for each skill in this activity. And then at the very bottom of this page, you're gonna see all the notes about this activity. And this is gonna help further explain what we were doing. You can add additional notes here, make it more personalized for each student. If you are personalizing these notes, and we're talking about Little Bo Peep, you wanna make sure that you are not sharing this with other families. So we would want to make sure we're doing this for just Little Bo Peep here. We can add a photo of the group or the student. We can make this visible to staff only. We can save this as a draft to come back later, maybe add those notes in here about Little Bo Peep. And then when we're done, we can click Add Observation. If we go under the student's profile, that is where you're going to be able to see that observation that we just made for today. You're also going to be able to pull up a report to see where the student is performing for all 35 skills. This is going to show you the most recent bench level for each skill and how many times we have done that activity. We also have a portfolio in here. Your teachers can come in and add photos, videos, observations, and notes within these portfolios. They can customize it for any date range that they'd like, and then they can move these around to make it more pretty however they'd like to. Once we share this with families, this is the view of the portfolio they will be able to see. The photos, the notes, the observations, all the above.